Oh, yeah. We're at it again. Another video. Another guest appearance by Eva. Is that your new scratching post? Is that the one? All right. Somebody's having too much fun, I think. Way too much fun. All right, so guys, very excited to... Oh, wow. She loves her shinies. Have I ever showed you guys how much she loves the shinies? Oh, yeah. Shiny time. If it shines, she's all about it. Eva, are those shinies? Do you have shinies? Oh, boy. You know, she likes cell phones. She'll swipe the screen. I guess those are shiny too, aren't they? Yeah. Well, anyway, we gotta get on with the show. Evie, what are you doing? Are you joining in the fun? Oh boy. All right, anyway, enough of that. We gotta get to the video, Eva. They want to see stuff. They don't just want to see you sitting there purring. Oh, no. They want to see the shinies. So, what'd we get? Well, as it turns out, quite a bit of stuff this week. Yeah, quite a bit of stuff. I'm slowing down on the purchases, guys. Here's a rubber band. I bet you'll like that. Did you get a rubber band? Did you get a rubber band? Ah, my finger. Anyway, we got some shinies, guys. Shiny City. Okay. And a fair amount of this I got under melt, which is pretty wild. Now, that was at the time of purchase. Silver's dropped a little bit since then, and quite honestly, I don't know how much the price is going to shift this week. I have a feeling that we might see a significant drop in everything real soon. I hope I'm wrong, but that's just my gut. My gut tells me silver's going to drop. The markets are going to drop. We might be in real trouble. But I hope I'm wrong. I hope I'm wrong. Gold's going to drop. Now, I will say, gold dropping and silver, if silver holds, you know, you might have an opportunity for a trade. So, if you're playing the GSR game. But, here, Eva, go chase the rubber band on the floor. Here, look, here it is. Here it is. Oh, you better get it. Oh. No, you don't want to get off here. So, yeah, you could play the GSR game. If silver holds relative to gold, you're going to have an opportunity to trade some stuff in. You know, and that's a great thing if you can find a willing participant in said trade. However, hopefully it's not a big market change the type that, you know, wipes out people's retirements and such. We don't want that. But we got to get to the goodies. So here we go. We're 5 minutes in and we haven't shown a single shiny. Hey, honey. Here we go. We got to make Eva go. All right. So right off the bat, we'll pull out the stuff I paid overmelt for. Some well overmelt. One was a big accident, actually. So here we go. These were my accident. These are Newfoundland sterling 5 cent coins, but when I bought them, I thought they were 10 cent coins. Even still, I paid $4.63, which is, you know, pretty near retail. Mintage is limited. This is the 41. I believe it's a 41. Yeah. So this coin had 600,000, you know. But of these coins, it's the biggest mintage, and it's dinged up. Look at that. So, see, that's kind of beat up there. So, you know, I overpaid. Thought they were 10-cent coins. This one's in better shape. But, again, it's the least key date of a series of coins that all have very small mintages. But this one's definitely in better shape and probably much closer to a $5 bill in value. So, there's that. All right. So, yeah, as I was saying, much closer in value to what I actually paid. So, not so bad. Some more coins I paid over melt for. This 1907 Piastre de Commerce from French Indochina. Not a bad little coin for $26.95, but definitely over melt. Still going to say, guys, if you can get a hold of these coins, get you one or two so you can oogle at their beauty. You know, very fine looking coin, very lovely design. Here's one in a much better shape, although that one's in decent shape. This is the 1936 50 cent coin. It was a one-year type, although they did make other 50-cent coins, but they say it's a one-year type anyway. $16.40 I paid for this, which is way above melt, but in this condition, I don't think you can go wrong with this coin. But tell me in the comments what you think. Okay, next I paid about $3 over melt for this coin. Go ahead and pull it out. Be gentle about it, though. It's an 80% coin from Sweden. The year was 1876. Paid, like I said, about $3 over melt for this. Maybe a little more. $9.62 for the coin. So, maybe $4 over melt. You know, not a bad coin, though. It's not in amazing shape, but it is probably worth every bit of $9.62. And if it isn't, oh well, it's cool. That is it on the stuff I paid over melt for. None of these, except maybe those fish scales, did I really overpay for, in my estimation. Now, let's get into some of the other stuff. I got 5 of the same coin and 1 oddball. So let's do the oddball first. This is the oddball. We've seen these before. Your Montreal $5 sterling silver Olympiad. Horribly ugly reverses on these. But the obverse isn't bad. This is not a proof coin. It's a business strike or regular strike, circulating strike. Although these were not circulating coins, they did come in these plastic holders, capsules, whatever you want to call them. You know, and I paid for that $19.16, which is definitely below melt. So that's a winner, winner, chicken dinner. I'm gonna make sure we don't see that reverse ever again. Okay, and then I got five of these, so I'll go ahead and show you. And we're gonna talk a little bit about this, what it is, why did they do it. So I'm sure all of you have seen the Canoe dollars from Canada. Some of the specs on these, it is a 36 millimeter diameter on these coins. So a bit smaller than, say, this coin, which is kind of close to a silver dollar size, to give you an idea. Actually, let me grab a silver dollar and give you a real indication. Here we go. Now, these are in the original mint packaging. Four of them are. I got five. One is not. So there you go. There's a size comparison. As you can see, yeah, very similar in size here and then a fair bit smaller there. So if you're wondering how big they are, it's still a good size coin though. And a very nice looking coin. So we're going to talk a little bit about what it is. What are we looking at here? So, obviously, Queen Elizabeth's on the obverse. It's a young head. This coin was made in 1964. There were about 8 million made, 7,600,000. So what is on the reverse? So let's go ahead and show that to you. Charlottetown, Quebec, 1864 to 1964. So what this coin actually is a commemorative of, it commemorates the signing or the meeting in Charlottetown where they laid the groundwork for later meetings, which led to the Confederation of Canada. So this was the early days. This would be like Independence Hall in Philadelphia, their equivalent. Now you'll notice some of the symbolism used. What we have here are some, well, you've seen these symbols before, I'm sure. So the first symbol up top is the Fleur de Lis. Or Fleur de Lis. I don't know. I'm not French. Fleur de Lis. So obviously Canada was a French holding initially, and there were still a lot of French people, especially in Quebec. So that represents them. And then to the right, we're just going to go clockwise here. That is a shamrock, and it represents the Irish. Although it's, you know, only got three leaves. A four leaf would be cooler, but that's just me. But yeah, it's a shamrock. It's a clover leaf, and it's the Irish. Then the Scottish down below that on the right, that's the thistle. And finally, the English rose. So you can see the rose, the thistle, the shamrock, and the fleur de lis. And this represents, yeah, Canada and the people of the times, and their want, their bid for independence, which was a peaceful transition, very different from what we had in the United States, which is pretty cool. All right, so that's one of them. We have five. So you don't think I'm kidding you. And all these I paid $15.58 each for. So here's the one that's out of its package. It's still in mint condition. But, you know, it's out of the package. So yeah, $15.58 is what I paid for all these each. The melt on them was definitely below that at the time of purchase. And guys, I didn't want to keep this video short and sweet, so that's all I got. Thanks for watching. Hope you have an amazing day. And do remember to get all the knick-knack, paddywhack. Give the dog a bone that you want to get. And if it's in your dreams, you know, and you can afford it and you're not breaking the bank or missing any bill payments, get it. Get it. Do it, guys. Do it. This is a little hint for our next video. Well, it might be, you know. So keep your eyes out for that and take care.